Now, it's interesting, about a month and a half ago, Colorado was tied with the Predators atop the Central Division. Now, in fifth in the division. So what's going on? Let's say hello to my friend Conor McGahey again. Talk to him. It seems like just yesterday, Conor, so nice to be back with you. And we're curious to find out, as we get closer to the All-Star break, how teams are at this final game, right? Are they jacked up, or are they just ready to shut her down? So what's your feeling around Colorado?
Well, as I talked to Jared Bednar this morning, he said that this game should not be a hard one to get up for. It's against the Minnesota Wild, arguably the Avs' biggest rival, and it's a cliche, but it's a four-point game tonight for the Avs against Minnesota. If the Avs lose and other teams win tonight, the Avs could find themselves in 11th place in the Western Conference. If they win, they'll have third place all to themselves. So it's a microcosm of how the Western Conference is working all alone. The good news for the Avs is they've had some success, but this season, there were nightmares for a long time. Last year, the Avs poured on the offense. 7-2 contest, 4 in the other, and the whole team has won both outings this year. So the Avs, I want to say, need this one tonight because it's obviously against a rival, but it means a lot for the standing.
All right, Connor, we're having some audio trouble, so let's see if it gets any better for the second question I'm going to throw at you about Philipp Grubauer. Starting for the first time in about 6 games, rust a factor at all, do you think?
I think he's been wanting to get back in the net. His last start was 2 weeks ago in Winnipeg. It was the first of a back-to-back, Avs in Winnipeg and then Avs in Calgary. And it wasn't the performance that Coach Bednar or I think Philipp Grubauer wanted. They've been trying to give each goaltender a chance to really take the reins and solidify a starting spot. It was only a couple months ago we were talking about the fact that the Avs had a 1 and a 1A goaltender situation. That really hasn't been the case. This will be Grubauer's first start in 6 contests, and he was good, especially on the road for the first couple months of the season. The goals against average, as you can see there, is over 3. Save percentage is under .895, and the save percentage between him and Semyon Varlamov over the past stretch has been about .850, which is definitely not good enough, especially for a team who's trying to get into the postseason.
All-Star weekend upon us, the top line for Colorado you've been talking about all year, been all world, it seems like. When you start discussing the festivities that are ahead of them in San Jose, how pumped are they?
It's a mixed bag. I mean, obviously, Gabriel Landeskog, believe it or not, has never been there before. Obviously, that's the case for Mikko Rantanen, too. The first trio, and guys, correct me if I'm wrong, we were looking back, the first line that will most likely play together at the All-Star game since the French Connection of the Buffalo Sabres. I could be wrong on that, but that's what we've come up with. But Mikko Rantanen and Nathan MacKinnon have been sort of attached at the hip. They're the first set of teammates with 70 points before the All-Star game since two guys named Mario Lemieux and Jaromir Jagr. So this has been the trio in the National Hockey League and for secondary in production behind that top line in Tampa with Stamkos, Kucherov, and Braden Point. So this has been the good news for the Colorado Avalanche this season, and it's no surprise when they don't register a point, like was the case on Monday, the Avs do not win, so they need to get on the score sheet tonight and head into that joyous All-Star game coming up in San Jose.
You can hear Conor McGahey on Altitude Sports Radio, but enjoy this right now. Look at the suit. I mean,
it's new.
Sharp,
you guys,
Conor.
Like it's a new one today. You guys like it?
I love it. I love it, Conor. Thanks again for hopping on. We'll talk to you soon.
My pleasure. See you.